Today, there have been over 8 million babies born through IVF. But in 1981, that number was only 15 born in the world and just one in the United States. My next guest was that one and only baby. And this monumental moment was so groundbreaking that it landed her on the cover of Life magazine as a toddler.
Elizabeth Carr has been in the media since she was 3 cells old. Born December 28, 1981 in Norfolk, Virginia, Elizabeth was the first baby born via in vitro fertilization in America. At the time, IVF research provoked fear and ethical concerns, which led to Elizabeth's family receiving harsh criticism from people around the world. But even then, her parents, Judith and Roger Carr, refused to remain anonymous. Now, Elizabeth, who just celebrated her 40th birthday, dedicates her life to advocating for women's fertility rights.
Please welcome TamFam Elizabeth Carr to the show. Elizabeth, thank you for joining us. Elizabeth, I love that you joke that you've been in the spotlight since you were 3 cells old. I've never shown this picture before, but this is Moses, my son, who's about to be 3. When at the bottom of our screen, he was just a few cells old. At the bottom, when I look at that picture of what was the transfer of my child to my body because of IVF, I marvel at it, and I thank you. Even though it was your parents, I thank you for this journey and what you do. Your parents were in their late 20s, early 30s when they had you. Your mom had had 3 ectopic pregnancies. And when they describe, how old were you when you were old enough to understand what they went through?
Oh, this is always such a hard question for me to answer because I feel like I've always known.
Really?
And so, you know, when you literally have your first baby photo at 3 cells old, you know, your parents go through the same conversations that every child goes through. Mommy and daddy couldn't have a child without the help of very special doctors. Mm. But then fast forward, I was about 7 years old and my 2 doctors sat me down and I watched the Nova documentary of my own birth. Ah. And they explained to me in great detail everything that was going on.
That's incredible. You know, when you think about IVF now, I mean, we're in year 2022, and I was looking back with my team at some of the articles and some of the criticism. It seems like it's a fantasy world miles away. But I know that there was a columnist by the name of Ellen Goodman who wrote what's been described as this piercing article criticizing your birth and IVF. And you actually had a chance to speak with her about that. What was that like to face the critics who said things, who I hope now they regret?
So ironically, Ellen's actually a really good friend of mine now. I used to work
really?
With her.
Really? Oh my gosh.
So, you know, we joke that, you know, she was just doing her job. But I think, you know, back then, most of the fear came from the same place that fear comes from now, that people just don't understand what's out there and what their options are. And so it's always been part of my mission to educate people about what's available.
Yeah. I mean, was it an inevitable life mission for you? Obviously, you could have been anything you wanted to be in this world, but that you work in this space of educating about women's rights and fertility in this journey, was it like almost like a calling, do you think?
Sure. I mean, I always joke that there's no good way to say thank you to an entire industry that brought you into this world. And so educating and advocating and joining, you know, the company that I'm at now, tomorrow, helping educate people about what's out there, it's kind of my love letter and thank you to the industry and all these scientists. I mean, they literally gave me life.
No, I'm telling you, I've never talked in great detail about my experience, but you know, there were days where I would look at, you know, these little cells and the doctor said, well, this one has a better chance. And my mother, who just celebrated her 72nd birthday, generationally, she's like, wait a minute, what? That's the baby? Wait a minute, they're going to put the, you know, the whole thing. And when we look at him now, knowing that I went through hundreds of needles and there's still a lot to learn about this journey, what do you think with the research and still some misunderstandings you would like people to know at this point about IVF that perhaps they don't get?
For me personally, I think the biggest thing is still really people don't know all their options. Yeah. You know, we hear so much about IVF, but a lot of people actually don't need IVF necessarily. They may need IUI or they might use donor egg or something like that. So there's a lot of other options out there. We just know about IVF because, you know, of people like me and my story. So
when you look at that three cell picture, I know I keep talking about my son, but I show him the picture and I'm like, who's that? He goes, that's me. When you look at the photo of the three cells, you think, that's me.
Yeah, it's funny because that picture, along with the Life magazine, hung in my parents' front hall when I was growing up. And, you know, slightly awkward to have your prom date come and pick you up. And you're like, oh, yeah, this is me half naked on a magazine cover. And oh, by the way, that blob is also me.
Well, listen, you are an amazing person. And what you do for others, to your point, in letting the families out there who want to be parents, that there are other options, is wonderful. So congratulations.